Hello viewers, today we will discuss about the basic concept of database management system. Database management system, basically first we will understand what is the definition of a database management system, what are the various concepts of database management system, what are the various terminology which are coming into this, we will discuss that. So there are some important basic concept which is there in the database system, like database schema, database model, data independence, DBMS architecture. This I am going to discuss in the basic concept part of the DBMS, because after knowing this you will be able to understand that how the basic design process of the database system succeed. Okay, then subsequently we will discuss how we can create a ER diagram, that is entity relationship diagram, and these are the various concepts which has been used: entity relationship, mapping cardinality and participation constraint. These are the basic constraint which we will be using in the construction of the ER diagram. Okay, so first we will start with the basic part of the database management system, like what is a database management system. So database management system is nothing but a software which handles all the access to the database. Okay, what is the data? So data, you can say, is a raw facts, you can say what you are, what related thing that you are collecting. Okay, and database is the collection of the those related object or those related things that make the database. And a software which handles all the access, all the kind of manipulation in the database is known as the DBMS, right? Now giving a brief of DBMS and how it is different from the file system, I will tell you that what are the various disadvantages of the file system approach, that is why the DBMS approach was there. So file system approach, you can assume with a simple example, like let's say you as a student take admission in a particular college or a university, then there may be separate department which will be requiring your information. So for example, there could be a admin department, there could be a hostel, and there could be your academic session. These three different applications may require to store your information. Let's say if we are storing this information in the file system approach, then what can happen, that admin may require your certain details, hostel may require your certain details, academic may require your certain details, and few details will be common into that. For example, your name, roll number, these are the things which are the common in all the application. Your phone number, contact number, these are the attributes which will be common in all these three applications, right? So let's say as a student, if you have to update some record, so you have to approach all these three departments separately, right? So in case if you forget to update a particular attribute of yours, then it may happen that the information, like let's say your roll number or let's say your phone number, maybe one at some place and maybe different at another place. Okay, so the repetition of the value is known as the data redundancy. Data redundancy. Okay, so when duplication of data is there, which is known as the data redundancy, and due to the data redundancy, when you try to update the values, when you try to manipulate the value, it may happen that you may forget to update some other places, right? This may lead to another problem which is known as the inconsistency. So data redundancy leads to inconsistency in the data, right? So these are the two major disadvantages of the file system approach. Another disadvantage of file system approach, that it is application specific. What do we mean by application specific? Application specific mean is that you are creating a separate application for admin, you are creating a separate application for hostel, you are creating a separate application for academic department. Okay, you are writing a separate program for all these three separate departments. So that is known as the application specific. So any kind of changes if you are doing, you have to change the entire program for that, right? Moreover, one of the things is that the data sharing is also very poor in file system management system. That is why we have a approach of database management system, where you can have a central table, name student, right? So student can be a central table in the database approach, and all other department can directly access to this central table, right? This will be a student table. So whatever information you are doing, that will be stored separately into the student table, and admin department, hostel department, and academic, they all will access the student table at one place. So no duplication of data, no redundancy in the data, so less chances of inconsistency in the data. So that is the purpose of the database system, that how database system is good than from the file system approach. There are certain other advantages also, like self-describing nature of the database. What do we mean by self-describing nature of the database? Self-describing nature of the database is mean that you, the database is stored all the information related to the database in itself only, which is known as the metadata. That is data about data. So all the user dictionaries, information about tables, information about indexes, sequences, these all are the things which are there in the database, are already stored into the metadata, which is the part of the database only. Okay, other than that, they enforce integrity. Enforce integrity. What do we mean by enforce integrity? That a database has to be correct in all the information. Your purpose to extract values from the database is that all the values should be correct. Okay, so integrity of the database should be maintained. No ambiguous data should be there. So these are the certain more advantages of the database approach that it provides. Another advantage is the sharing of the data. Data sharing is easy in the database approach compared to the file system approach. So these are the basic differences between the file system approach and the database system approach. Now coming back to our basic concept that we are discussing about the database management system. First thing that we understand is known as the database schema. What is the database schema? The description of the database is known as the database schema. How we describe it, right? So we can describe like what are the various attributes in that, what are the various data type in that. So description at and description of the database can be at various level. So this we can easily understand with the help of our architecture of the DBMS. This is the architecture of the DBMS. Three layer architecture, we can say the three layer. The first is the external level. Here is the end user. Then you have the conceptual level. Then we have internal level, right? This is the three layer architecture of the DBMS, and this is the stored database. So description of the database can be at the various level. The user, through with the help of the application program, understand that how the external schema is there, right? At the conceptual level, the user designs the database. So there you need to have the description about the various design features. Like what are the attribute will be there, what is the various number of tables will be there, etc. And at the internal level, it is related with the storage of the data only, right? So these are the various, you can say, the sequences and the schema description at various level in the database approach. Now, second thing is the database model. What is the database model? So database schema is the description of the database, while the database model is the structure of the database, that how you actually going to store your database, right? So there are various database models, and you can categorize them into like there is a high level model, also known as the conceptual. We have a low level model, which is used for the storage purpose only. Okay, high level and low level model. So high level model, basically this is regarding how the user going to perceive the data. Okay, so it can be like in the form of the implementational or relational model. Like relational model is a one kind of implementation model, and low level means which is related with the storage only. How the database structure is managed to store the database, that is at the low level in the particular thing, right? Here in between these two categories, we can find a category where you can let's say how to represent that data The representation of the data is also important. So representation of data can be done in the various ways, like we have relational model, we have other model also, like hierarchical model is also there, or network model is also there, but they have been obsolete now then. But the most important model is the relational model, okay, which is in the use and proposed by Dr. E.F. Codd. Okay, so when we discuss about the conceptual data model is related with the design of the database. So design of the database, when we say how we have to design the table, let's say somebody asks you to prepare a database. You went to a shopkeeper, or you went to a mall, or you went to a some industry or hospital or anywhere. Okay, you can create the database for any application, but how to start to create that? How you can start creating that database is that important part. So for that, you need to understand the basic concept of conceptual modeling. Okay, that conceptual data modeling, which is the one of the type of database model, and the popular conceptual modeling is the ER diagram. So entity relationship diagram helps to create the initial design for the database approach.